Parliament's committee, which is inquiring into alleged mismanagement of savers' money at the National Social Security Fund, NSSF, has quizzed the Minister of Gender, Betty Amongi, over the $1.8 billion budget flagged as corporate social responsibility, which allegedly turned out to be a cash bonanza shared among board members and the minister herself. The minister was allegedly allotted 250 million shillings, 200 million shillings for chairperson board, and 400 million shillings for each workers' union for donations.
Is this true?
Can I see it? Because I am telling you, I'm the one who passed the budget. I'm the one who approved it. And I have given you the budget I approved. And it doesn't have 1.8 billion.
How much
for
does it
corporate
have?
Social responsibility? The former MD and the chair came to me and told me that in Mbarara, they had discussed as a board about corporate social investment.
Amongi distanced herself from the cash bonanza, saying it was a proposal initiated by the former NSSF managing director Richard Biarugaba and the NSSF board chairperson Peter Chimbawa. She told the committee that she opposed the idea immediately after learning about it because it was against the normal practice.
They had came to me with the chairman and told me that this is the idea they have come up with from the board of doing a corporate social investment where the minister will be donating, the chairman will be donating, the board members will be donating.
Amongi faced off with Biarugaba before the probe committee as the latter accused the minister of requesting for 6 billion shillings from NSSF for the Ministry of Gender to use to sensitize and educate workers and also mobilize new savers. But Amongi tasked her accusers to table evidence of the letter that requested for the said money.
Tell us about the meeting, the heated meeting about the 6 billion, because there were allegations here that you actually went and said, you told the former MD that why did you go and report to finance, yet you're the one who pushed for this?
Not requested for money from the fund. And last time when I appeared before you, I said, can you give me any documentation that is with you that somebody has brought?
When the minister asked us to provide for the activities, we said we had already done so. So I would not have expected when the letter came for the minister now to be saying we should allocate 6 billion shillings for the same activities which were already in the budget.
The committee has also grilled Minister Amongi over her relationship with one Job Richard Matua, a whistleblower who sparked off the NSSF probe. Committee members wondered the ease at which Matua seized documents from the minister.
Before he called you, like you have said, did you know him before? And for how long had you known him?
Job Matua called me and said, I am not happy as a cadre that you people are disagreeing on a matter on principle.
A WhatsApp communication, apparently from between you and a certain A. I might use A. I don't know if you, I'll read it and give it to you. I'll just share with you one copy. It states, but I told him before I commissioned the investigation to write to me and withdraw his interest so that I don't investigate him.
The committee also interrogated Amongi over the two board members that voluntarily resigned and were compensated 700 million shillings, which was irregular.
You initiated a process of paying them a package which was not from any policy framework of NSSF, and each one of them was paid 312 million shillings.
No objection, and I indicated in my letter that you are required to do this within the NSSF policy and legal framework.
Still, Biarugaba had another outburst with the minister, accusing her of tarnishing his name in the press over allegations that Biarugaba has been casually giving away savers' money to moneylenders in town to make profits. But Amongi denied making such utterances.
Gender, Labour and Social Development Minister Betty Amongi says her refusal to reappoint Mr. Richard Biarugaba as managing director of NSF was backed by evidence of financial impropriety in the running of the fund. Amongi says savers' money was being given to moneylenders in town to make profits.
I'm going to view my interview and it will form part of my response when I'm writing.
The committee has wrapped up the inquiry to head for a retreat where they're going to review evidence and write a report to be presented to Parliament after the ongoing fortnight recess. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.